that even mean, Bauer's Game Corner?
Oh, hi there, YouTube. I'm back again today for another game review, a special expansion review. And today I'm very excited to be checking out Zombie Dice 3, the school bus expansion from Steve Jackson Games. This is for two to as many players as you want to play it with. It's for ages, I'd say, about 12 and up. It'll take you 10-15 minutes to play. And in Zombie Dice 3, the school bus expansion, you are going to be taking your zombie on the bus, trying to eat a bunch of brains, not get ran over by the bus, not have people jump off the bus, and, well, not get shotgunned in the face, just like typical zombie dice. Full disclaimer, you do need to have the regular version of Zombie Dice in order to play the school bus expansion. Is it must-own? Is it great? Let's open up and see how it works. Alright then, we're going to take a look at what you're going to get inside of the Zombie Dice 3 school bus expansion for the original base game of Zombie Dice. So first and foremost, we got our handy-dandy rule sheet. It's about a half of a page, double-sided, full color, but only for the advertisement on the back. All of this is just advertisement, so really, it's less than a full page. It's a very simple rule sheet. It'll have you up and running in no time. I will say you will need to come back to it from time to time just to remember what all the different symbols mean, but once you've played three or four games, you probably won't need it ever again. So next, you got your rule sheet. You're going to get these little counters, and these are going to keep track of what you're doing on the school bus. There's going to be brain counters, and there's going to be shotgun counters, because you can get hurt or score brains when you are riding the aforementioned school bus, which is going to be the new die you're going to get. Really cool looking, yellow, nicely ingrained, and it's going to have a bunch of different symbols on it. We will get to the symbols at the end of this gameplay explanation, but for now, let's just show you how this game is going to work. This expansion is going to work. So, first thing you're going to know is that not too much changes with the basic rules. You're actually going to start off, and you're not going to have the school bus dice in the tube. You're actually going to have it set over to the side, and when you take your first roll, you're going to reach into the tube, and you're going to grab three dice. So you can't roll the school bus the very first roll. You're going to roll them and see what happens. So we got 2 feet and a brain. So, at this point of the game, I can either decide that I will stop with my 1 point, bawk, 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 if you want to be a chicken, you can do that, or you can draw back into the tube and grab one more additional dice to roll, so you're rolling three regular six-sided dice, or you can say, I'm going to ride the school bus, which means you're going to add this dice, and this will be one of your three dice. You're always, just like in the base game, only going to be rolling three dice, even if you are rolling the super fancy dice. So we're going to do that so we can show you exactly how it works. So you're going to roll up those three dice, see what happens. And that was a pretty good roll. We have a brain, we have double brain, which means we will use two of these tokens, put them over here, and then we have a foot, which is a great example. Because in the normal game, you would just say, oh, I'm going to re-roll this foot and continue to chase him. However, when you're on the bus, that actually means that that person ran and jumped off the bus. So that means you're going to put them over there. You may no longer go after them as long as you are on the bus. So at this point, you have a couple choices. You can either jump off the bus, which means you'd set your yellow school bus die to the side and go chase after this guy, which means you'd put this six-sided die back in play. And then at that point, you would draw two new dice to roll, or you can continue to stay on the bus, which means you're going to draw two completely new die, which means, well, you might do that. So we're going to say, for this argument's sake, that this guy's going to continue to stay on the bus. He's going to grab two more dice, and he's going to continue to roll on. So he got another brain, he got another brain, which means he's up to six, and then this guy ran away again. And he would continue probably to go on, and he would say, I'm going to keep pushing my luck, and he's going to once again just roll and continue to go. So, dead end, that's great because I can show you exactly what one of the special sides of the die will do. So the dead end is one you like to see because that means the runners are trapped. Which is not good for the people who, well, it's not good for these pretend feet we have here, because that means that they are stuck and they are going to become brains. So that would be fantastic for you, because that red die is now going to become a brain. And as you can see, I'm having an absolutely spectacular roll right now. I have 8. So at this point, you would continue either to A, jump off the bus and try and go after these yellow feet, or B, stop, take your 8 points over here, or C, grab two more dice from over here and continue to roll. We'll just say we'll do that, and we'll see what happens. Wow, I cannot believe I'm doing this good. I got 2 double brains from the bus, so 1, 2. I got 1 single brain right here, and I got a shotgun, which means I am up to...
I am up to 11 brains, which means at this point I could stop or I could try and win the game in one turn, potentially, by getting to 13, which I can't believe I'm catching this on camera. We're going to go ahead and do, and we're even going to give ourselves some hard ones. We're going to go with the jock and the red, and we're going to roll it up one more time, see what happens, and we got... Ooh, yeah, we got it! We got a shotgun, and we got 3 brains, which means we'd go... one brain over here, brain over here, shotgun over here, and we are going to stop as quick as humanly possible, and we'd say, alright, on this turn I got 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 brains on the first turn. You guys need to beat that. I will say, this does not normally happen. In fact, this has never happened before this review, so big thumbs up for me. So that's how that's going to work. Other than that, once you get 3 shotguns, you are going to be out of the game, unless, of course, you're playing with the Santa expansion, which will give you the helmet. But let's go on to all the different symbols that are on the dice. You obviously know, you know, you got your typical brains and shotguns, brains, shotguns, shotguns, brains, brains, brains. We talked about the dead end, which is going to turn all the feet that you roll that turn into brains. Next, let's get to the stop sign. This is one you don't normally want to see. The stop sign means, well, you have to stop. The school bus has stopped, which means your turn is over immediately. If you do get 3 shotguns, you still are dead and score nothing. But if you don't, you score whatever brains you have left, and you can't continue to roll. Your turn is over, even if you don't want it to be over. So normally you don't want to see the stop sign. Next is the yield sign, which means it's going to turn all the shotguns that you rolled only on this turn, so not shotguns that are over here, but the ones you just rolled, into feet. So that is pretty good, because that's going to help you out. Then last but not least, we have this right here, which is the run over, drop a brain. This is not one you want to see. That means that you have fallen off the bus and you've got ran over. What that means is you're going to lose either a brain token, or you're going to lose a brain die, and you'll just put that right back into the cup like so. And then you're also done driving the bus, which means then you can continue to keep going, or you can just stop right there. And that is what you're going to be getting inside of the Zombie Dice 3 School Bus expansion. Alrighty then, Zombie Dice, the School Bus expansion, one of my final thoughts. Let's go over the pros, let's go over the cons. First, on the con side, the game's not going to be for everybody. In fact, if you didn't like the original Zombie Dice, I don't see this really swaying you into thinking, man, I gotta go get Zombie Dice and try it now with that new expansion. There's nothing too groundbreaking or earth-shattering here that changes how the game plays or feels for the most part. Also, this is a comment I had from someone that said they felt like it made the game a little bit easier. It shortened up the game, which for some people isn't necessarily going to be a con, but I definitely can say that if you roll lucky, as you can see as I did in the gameplay video, this will shorten up the length of the game once you start getting those triple brains, especially if you got triple brains and a Santa Claus or something like that. I mean, you can really end the game a lot quicker with this, which I personally like, but I can't understand why some people didn't like. Last but not least, you know, this Zombie Dice with both the expansions or just plain is all about luck. And some people aren't going to like the luck of the dice, and it is all about the dice. Now, there is a little added bit of strategy here because you have to decide, okay, as always, do I stay, do I keep going, or do I stop? But in this one, you say, all right, do I stay on the bus, or do I keep going and try and run those green feet over there, which is going to be easier, but I can't get back on the bus if I get off the bus. But for the most part, it's still just chucking dice and just hoping you don't get shotguns. Moving on to the pros, I really enjoy Zombie Dice. I really enjoyed the second Zombie Dice expansion with Santa and the jock and the cheerleader, and I really enjoy the third expansion for Zombie Dice. I hope there's a fourth expansion, even though we're getting awfully tight in here. But let's get over to the pros. First, on the pro side, you can fit all of the expansions with the rules into the base Zombie Dice little tube, which is a big thumbs up for me that when there's 2 expansions in here and it still fits. Now, it's getting tight, but it still fits in there, so that's a big thumbs up. Also, the dice, the components, very nicely made. The tokens are nice. The die looks really, really cool, and it's aesthetically pleasing. Like, I like how it's, like, it's, what is it, 10 or 12 sided, it'll roll a couple times. You'll be like, yeah, stop there, and then it'll roll again. You'll be like, oh, no. It adds a little extra element of fun there. I like the fact that you can get 3 brains, or you can get 2 shotguns in there, or you can fall off the bus. They have some interesting mechanics on how the dice works and what it does. I like that an awful lot. So the question here, I think, is which expansion do I prefer? Do I prefer the one with Santa Claus, or do I prefer this one right here? $1 million question. And it's tough, because I love Santa Claus. I love getting those energy drinks and the helmet. I think that's awfully cool. But I'm going to have to lean over towards the School Bus expansion. I think both are fantastic, and if you like Zombie Dice, I think they're both must-owns.
But I think I like the school bus a little bit better just because it does shorten up the game in my experience just by a smidge, which is always good, I think, when you can shorten up a game. And it, you know, sometimes in Zombie Dice when you're down, like, say, 1 to 10 or something like that, you're like, oh, man, I got no chance of coming back. But with the school bus, I mean, as you can see from the gameplay, you can just start 3 brains, 2 brains, start rolling off points. Like, oh, there's 2 shotguns, but I got this, so it just turns them into feet. And I like that an awful lot. I personally like it best when you mix in the Santa Claus and the jock and the cheerleader and the school bus. I think that just adds a whole extra layer of fun to what was already a perfectly enjoyable game. Overall, Zombie Dice, the school bus expansion, if you like Zombie Dice, what are you doing? Go buy it. It's fantastic. It's a lot of fun. It adds just another unique amount, layer to an already fun game. So, if you enjoyed this content, please be sure to click on the subscribe button down below. Also, in the comments below, let me know, did you enjoy riding the school bus as a child? I was a really bad kid. Like, I was terrible. My bus driver, Jack, used to hate our guts. We used to live all the way out in the country, and so we would have to get on the bus really early, and it'd be like really dark outside, and so we would just be throwing stuff all the time on the bus. I remember I hit this kid once in the eye with a spoon. He had to go to the hospital. It was terrible, but I didn't get caught. But after that, they installed lights on the bus. But either way, I really enjoyed the bus. I had a lot of fun times on the bus, just tomfooling, except when I was in the front because I was a bad kid. But anyway, did you enjoy riding the bus? Did you ride the bus? Do you ride the city bus? Tell me about your bus experience down in the comments below. And as always, thanks for your time, YouTube.
That was the review for the Zombie Dice 3 School Bus Expansion. For more reviews and previews, check back at Bowers Game Corner.